Hi everyone, this is Lin Chan Leighton, attorney and partner here at JLJ Law Group, and I'm joined here by Victoria Wang, who will be doing the Chinese portion of our video.
今天很高兴又跟大家见面了，继续我们的美国移民视频系列讲座的第十一集. This is our 11th.
Oh, wow, okay. Well, welcome again, and thanks for joining us. So today we're going to quickly talk about a few things. So the first one we're going to talk about is chefs, because we've gotten a lot of questions about chefs and some of the concerns that some of the owners might have of being able to petition certain chefs.
那么今天呢，我们是又是礼拜一了，我们争取每个星期一呢做一集新的专辑啊。那么首先呢，我们两个商量一下，就是还是回答一些大家最关心的中国大厨师来美国的绿卡申请。那经常会有一些人问到一些问题，那么我们今天和陈律师一起呢，跟大家再 clarify 一下。 You want to say this is not a legal advice?
Yes. Yep. I was just going to get to that. So again, all the information that we give on this video is always just general advice. It's not considered legal advice. Everybody's situation is different.
那么我也提醒陈律师呢，我们每次在视频当中跟大家介绍的都是一个广义的介绍，不是个案的法律建议。那如果您有个案的法律建议需要跟律师了解的话呢，欢迎你到我们办公室来做一个咨询。
Great. And then also, because immigration is federal law, we even though I'm located in Utah, we can help anybody located in any state or anywhere in the world as long as we're advising on immigration, U.S. immigration law.
那么呢，因为也是美国的移民法是联邦法，虽然我们是在犹他州的，如果在美国其他地方或者世界各地，如果您想了解美国的移民法跟相关的问题或者有相关的需要，我们都可以为您提供服务。
So we're also going to talk about U.S. citizens petitioning for spouses and U.S. citizens petitioning for fiancés, because we've gotten some questions about that as well. So we'll just talk about processing times for those types of cases.
那么今天呢，我们也会接触另外两个话题，一个就是美国公民申请他的未婚妻，还有一个美国公民跟一个另外的配偶结婚这样的一个签证的一些问题。So
the question that we've gotten a lot from restaurant owners about petitioning for chefs, and really this can apply to any employer who's petitioning for an employee to get their green card, is what if they've only been open for a few months? Like if the business has been open for a few months, can that employer still petition for a worker?
那么今天我们谈到的就是在一个EB3项下的，就是由雇主申请雇工的这样的一个情况。那么很多时呢，这个生意是刚刚起步，可能才开了3个月、几个月。 那么，这项的情况不单单是中国的大厨，就是其他的开做生意的人都有这样的问题。那这种情况下，生意才开了几个月，那么雇主能不能申请雇员呢？
So what immigration looks at is how much money does the business make, and can the business make enough money to be able to cover all expenses like employees, operating costs, and do they make enough money to cover this new employee?
那么其实移民局要看什么呢？就是看这个生意，在这个生意项下呢，产生不产生足够多的利润，可以支付你所有的开销，那支付你其他员工的费用，还有支付你这个经营这个方面的费用，包括你有没有钱支付这个新员工，这是移民局要看的问题。So
for businesses that haven't been operating too long, you can base your financials on projections. So usually most businesses will have some sort of business plan where they have their financials and they can project, okay, 2 years from now, 3 years from now, 5 years from now, this is where we will be.
Oh, okay. So they can do projections, right? 那么所以呢，一般情况下呢，我们可以看这个一个展望，一个预测，就是说你在未来的一年、两年，你有生意计划，那么你这个生意呢会赚到多少钱？ 所以说，虽然您才开了几个月，开了半年或者是8个月，可能是这个时间比较短，但是移民局可以看你的这个生意在未来的一两年当中或者3年当中会赚多少钱。所以呢，批不批呢，也会看它的 projection， 就是对未来的一个预测。
And there are a few steps involved before you even get to the point of having to show your finances. So there's still the Department of Labor part, which can take about a year, I would say close to a year, because that part has to be done before any of the immigration stuff can be submitted. So the financials are relevant at the stage of the immigration part where the employer will have to show their taxes and financials.
That's very clear, right? That's a good point. 那就是说什么呢？有的时候呢，因为我们这个劳工申请这一块呢是分三步走的。那第一步呢，我们需要跟美国的劳工部打交道。那这段时间呢，要花一年的时间。所以这个阶段呢，你暂时先不要看他的那个财务报表。那差不多一年左右了，那么我们到移民局这个第二步骤了，才需要你出示你的申请人公司的这个雇主的这个生意的财务报表、财务情况、这个经营的利润和盈利情况。所以说还有差不多一年的时间走。It's about a year, huh?
I would say so. I mean, it's close to about a year. And for the most part, I would say that it seems like at least the people who are asking you questions, they've at least been operating for a few months, right?
那么之所以我们有这个问题呢，就是很多人都在问我说我的生意才开张啊，我也没有很多的这个挣钱的这个赚钱的这个这个证据和历史啊，怎么移民局怎么看？所以真正的我们要出示这些财务方面的情况呢，也是差不多一年以后了。等我们跟这个劳工部的这个过程做完了，所以说呢，这段时间你已经有了一年的业绩了，是吧？再加上你未来一两年的这个 projection， 应该是可以的了。So the bottom line is the conclusion is it's not a problem for an employer just to open a business for like a half a year or a couple of months, right?
Right.
So they can still petition their potential employee.
Right.
Yeah, perfect. 那我的意思就跟他再确认一下，说那结论性就是什么呢？虽然您的生意刚刚开张不久，您也可以同样申请啊，您需要的雇员、雇工。Great.
Yeah. So then we're going to talk about U.S. citizens petition for spouses versus a U.S. citizen petition for a fiance. So we've gotten several.
By the way, I may interrupt you. Say another thing. Often asked questions: how long the whole process may take?For apply for like a chef from China.
Okay, from China. So it's about 2.5 to 5 years.
Yeah.
I would say. I know it's kind of a big time range, but it really depends on how quickly immigration operates, how quickly the clients give us the documents we need to be able to process things.
那么还有一个经常问到的问题呢，就是说，哎，这段过程要多久呢？我们等待这个大厨从中国来到美国，因为大家都很急，需要这个厨师来工作，要等多久呢？其实我们接触的个案呢，理论上说是4到5年，但是我们个案当中有2年半、3年、2年8个月，三年多就来的这样的一个成功的例子。那么我们可以说呢，它时间是从两年半到5年这个等候时间。那么完全取决于你有多快把材料都交给我们，多快律师把材料交给移民局。所以说呢，如果说你把资料提交的很快，那么整个流程就做得很快，所以您的员工可以快点来呀。So really depend upon how fast we, you know, submit the documents, required documents.
Right. And we really don't have any control over how long these agencies take either, because things are always changing and how they review cases can always change as well.
那么同时呢，我们也确实很难控制美国政府的这些部门，他们需要花多少时间。那么经常的情况下呢，这个会比较有一些变化。那么目前来说，在现任政府下呢，这个移民比较缩紧的这个政策缩紧，那么它的很多的程序也审查的比较严格，那可能目前呢就是等候时间稍微长一些。但是总体来讲，大厨师的申请到美国一般是2年半到5年之间，看个案。Good, we're clear.
All right, so going back to the U.S. citizen petition for a spouse versus petition for a fiance. So sometimes we have clients who ask, well, what's better? Should we get married first and then I petition for my spouse as a spouse visa, or should I petition for him or her with a fiance visa?
那经常呢，我们这里面就是美国公民跟已婚的配偶，这个办绿卡，还是一个就是说，美国公民跟一个未婚妻或未婚夫申请绿卡。那么经常有人说，我是要先结婚呢，办绿卡好呢，还是说还没有结婚呢，办绿卡好？所以今天我们回答一下这方面的问题。
So again, this is going to be very, very general. Every case is very specific, and so we could keep talking for a while about this. So I'm just going to give very general information about processing time.
那么今天呢，我们也是一个总结性的哈，一个广义的，把这个申请的这段处理时间跟大家介绍一下。这完全不是个案，因为每个人情况完全不一样。我们今天谈的也是个广义的啊，广义的一个介绍。
So for a U.S. citizen to petition for a spouse who is abroad, like not living here, the first petition takes anywhere from 8 to 10.5 months to get approved.
那么如果说一个美国公民申请他在国外的配偶，就是已经结婚了，那目前的时间呢是8个半月到10个半月这样的等候时间。
And then after that, it takes about 30 to 60 days for the case to be transferred to another government agency.
那么在等接下来批下来以后呢，就是30到60天，这个资料呢会转到美国的另一个部门。
So that agency is responsible for collecting certain documents, and there's an online visa application that has to be filled out. So once that agency gets everything, it takes them about 60 days to process all of that.
那么这段过程呢，他说是叫60天时间啊，他说都叫 agency，就是美国虽然都是申请绿卡，有不同的 agency。So you talk about now we kind of little bit broad topic. You talk about agency. They are not under immigration, so different agencies or one
So
called.
the first one is U.S. Citizenship and Immigration
So
Services.
USCIS.
That's the first agency that someone's going to deal with to file the petition. The second agency you deal with is the National Visa Center.
Oh, National Visa Center. OK，那么我们刚才介绍的8个半月到10个半月的等候时间是美国移民局，就是 U.S. Citizen Service Center。第二个是 National Service Visa
National Visa
Center
Center.
Visa Center。第二个这个处理的政府部门呢是叫美国的这个签证中心，需要30到60天的时间。
Yeah, so once the NVC receives everything they need, it takes about 60 days for them to process everything on their end.
那么这个 National Visa Center 它收到所有的资料以后呢，它一般也需要60天的时间处理这些文件。
And then once they have everything, they will then schedule the appointment at the US Embassy where your spouse is.
那么他们文件处理好以后呢，他就跟您的先生或太太约好在美国的一个领馆进行面试，驻中国的一个美国领馆进行面试。
And every consulate's a little bit different, so if it's a busier consulate, it might take a little longer for the interview to be scheduled. If it's not so busy, maybe a little sooner. But I would say it's once the National Visa Center has said, okay, we've received everything. They will send an email saying, okay, you are now in queue for an interview. And usually I've seen it's about 3 months out from the time you get the email that they've now put you in line. So then it's about another 3 months for the interview to actually happen.
总而言之，他的意思就是说，要看中国你是在哪一个领事馆，进行面试的，因为每个领事馆的这个根据他处理的东西的时间呢，可能每个领馆等候的时间都不一样。Yes, interesting. I just saw a Chinese article talking about they did a little data survey and say which one maybe prove faster or prove percentage higher. It's interesting. Just so like just match what you said. Depend upon each consulate, their process time. So 然后呢，他们还要再等差不多3个月，然后去让你进行面试。
So I would say for the spouse visa, I would expect the minimum time is a year.
那么所以呢，刚刚介绍完以后呢，就是大家看从头到尾啊，总共的时间差不多1年时间，就是美国公民申请在国内的配偶。
But I would say it'll probably be closer to a year and a half.
1年到1年半嘛，1年到1年半 close 就是接近1年到1年半的时间，1年左右。
Now, for a fiance visa, so only US citizens can do the fiance visas, let's say. And the processing period for a fiance visa is actually a little bit shorter.
Oh,
So
really?
it's about, with USCIS, the fiance petition is about 5 to 7 months to process. Instead of the 8 to 10 and a half.
OK。那么刚刚我们讲过了，美国公民和他的配偶，在国内的配偶、国外的配偶，这个过程呢，就是 USCIS 要花8个半月到10个半月。那这里面呢，到10到9个月，seven to
Five to seven
nine，oh,
months
five to seven
for the
months，sorry，
fiance.
就5到7个月，哇，就能够了啊，搞到了。那么这个他说的是，只有美国公民才能申请未婚妻或未婚夫的签证。是5到7个月，在 USCIS 这里面。
So then also, then once USCIS approves, it goes to the National Visa Center. They collect their documents there, and then they schedule the interview
OK，
at the
那
US consulate.
same thing 哈，然后接下来呢，就到美国签证中心，国家签证中心呢，这个地方呢，也是要把所有的文件都收集好。How long this may take? Same thing.
So no, it should be a little shorter for the fiance to be able to come here on the visa. I would say it's more like it could be more like a year. as far as the time frame.
But before you said 30 to 60 days.
Right.
For national visa center. Mm-hmm. But this will be a year?
No, sorry. So I'm talking about overall.
Okay.
So when you count in the national visa center, then you count the waiting time to get the interview scheduled.
Mm-hmm.
So you're looking at, so assuming it takes 7 months to process the fiance okay. visa, and then you have to wait another at least 30, 60 days for it to get transferred mm-hmm. to the national visa center. So let's say it takes 60 days and it took 7 months to process the fiance mm-hmm. petition. So now you're at 9 months.
Mm-hmm. So what about the total?
So then it takes another, I would say a year, approximately a year.
那么最多呢,他说这个申请未婚妻未婚夫的签证的话呢, 就是在一年以内哈。 那么配偶呢,是一年到一年半。
Okay. Now, if it only takes 5 months for immigration to process the petition, then obviously it'll be a lot faster than a year.
Yeah. 总之五到七个月嘛,就是看的,总之这段时间比那个申请公民申请配偶要省了三个月的时间。
Okay. Now, with a fiance visa, once a fiance gets the visa to come, the citizen and fiance must get married within 90 days.
Oh,
and then
in the U.S.
In the U.S. Uh-huh. And then once they get married, the now spouse can apply for the green card in the U.S.
那么他说这个未婚妻未婚夫签证来到美国以后呢, 必须 90天以内马上结婚。 结婚好以后呢,然后再可以申请绿卡。 Okay.
Yeah, so I would say that it's the spouse visa takes longer, but the spouse will get their green card faster through the spouse visa.
Okay.
With the fiancé visa, the fiancé gets to come to the U.S. sooner, but it will take them longer to get the green card.
How long then?
Well, in Utah, the last I looked, the time frame for processing is... It was like 9.5 to 22 months is the processing time they gave.
9.5 to 22 months. This is for a
green card.
Green card for spouse?
For spouse if you're in Utah.
Okay. And what about a fiance?
Well, so this is what I was referring to is when the fiance comes,
mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
they get married and then the fiance applies to the green card.
Oh,
and let's assume that they're in Utah.
Okay, what about spouse then?
Well, once a spouse gets a spouse visa, they come to the US, there's an immigrant visa or an immigrant fee that they pay,
mm-hmm.
and then the green card gets mailed.
Really? Oh my gosh. 那这样子的话，大家还是先结婚吧，哈哈，先结婚吧，再来。刚刚我再跟他说，因为我今天比较赶时间，一会儿还有一个会。他说，如果是你是靠那个未婚妻未婚夫的签证进到美国来的， 90天以内你必须结婚，那么你在等候绿卡的时间就比较长了，要9个半月到22个月的等候时间，目前哈。 那么还是说在我们州，可能在其他州更长一点。但是如果说你的配偶就是在国内配偶申请的绿卡，申请的这个绿卡签证到美国以后，很快交了这个绿卡的这个费用以后，很快就会给你寄一张绿卡过来的。那么就是说那个配偶会得到绿卡很快，虽然来到美国时间会长一些，但是来到美国以后拿到绿卡很快。 那么这个未婚妻来的可能很快，但是拿到绿卡的时间会等的比较久。
Okay, good, clear.
Yep.
All right, so that is it for today.
All right.
Thank you so much for joining us. And if you have any questions, you can visit our website at jljlawgroup.com. We also have a Chinese line that Victoria can answer, and that phone number is 385-220-4468. And then she also has a WeChat, which is China Cool Bean. And then our office line is 801-883-8204.
I think that we can just use this number for the Chinese.
Yes, that's for the English one. 那么呢，陈律师说，欢迎大家有任何需要跟我们联系。那么陈律师的事务所叫JLJ Law Group，
你可以看JLJLawGroup.com是他们的 website， 同时呢，Miss Chen 有她的Facebook 的 webpage。 Facebook 你可以 follow 啊，另外呢，所有的中文热线都请打给我这条专线 385-220-4468 你也可以加我的微信叫 China 大写的 C Cool C O O L B E A N 是一个字，那欢迎您跟我们联系。Thank you, Miss Chen, for your time today.
Thanks, Victoria. Then we'll see you next time.
See you next time. 下次见。